Mathematics
Chapter 14 Standard 10 Statistic. Now introduction to statistic. Ungrouped data. Ungrouped data is a data in its original or raw form. The observation are not classified into group. For example, the ages of everyone present in a classroom of kindergarten kid with the teacher is as follow: 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 27. So these are the ages of the students with the teacher. This data shows that there is one adult present in the class, that is age 27, and that is the teacher. Ungrouped data is easy to work when the data set is small. Now when we talk about group data, in group data, observations are organized in group. For example, a class of students got different mark in school exam are, this table is tabulated as, means the data is tabulated as marks interval number of students. Now marks in the range of 10 to 20, 21 to 40, 41 to 60, 61 to 80, 81 to 100. Now marks interval, that is the range given to us. Number of students in 10 to 20 is 13. Number of students in 21 to 40 is 9, 41 to 60, 36, 61 to 80, 32, 81 to 100, 10. This shows that how many students got particular marks range. Group data is easier to work with when a large amount of data is present. Frequency. Frequency is the number of time a particular observation occurs in the data. Average. So average, that is x bar, sum of total observation upon number of observation. So x1 plus x2 plus up to xn are the number of observation upon total number of observation is n. So upon n. So 1 upon n into sigma. Sigma means sum total. So sigma x, xi, that is I from 1 to n. So x bar equals to sigma x upon n. Frequency is the number of times a particular observation occurs in data. Class interval, data can be grouped into class intervals such as all the observation in that range belongs to that class. Class width, that is upper class limit minus lower class limit. So mean, finding the mean of group data when class intervals are not given. So for group data without class interval, mean equals to x bar, that is sigma xi fi upon sigma fi, where fi is the frequency of ith observation, that is xi. Class mark is equals to upper class limit plus lower class limit upon 2. There are three ways for finding the mean. First one is direct method. In direct method, we see the steps involved in that. First step is classify the data into intervals and find the corresponding frequency of each class. Step two, find the class mark by taking the midpoint of upper and lower class limit. Step three, tabulate the product of class mark and its corresponding frequency for each class. Calculate their sum, sigma xi fi. And step 4, divide the above sum by the sum of frequency, sigma fi, to get the mean. Mean by group data. The mean for group data can be found by the following method. First one, direct method. So x bar equals to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. Frequency of the class is centered at its midpoint, called the class mark. Exercise 14.1, question number 1. A survey was conducted by a group of students as a part of their environment awareness program, in which they collected the following data regarding the number of plants in 20 houses in a locality Find the mean number of plants per house. Which method did you use for finding mean and why? Number of plants in the range is 0 to 2, 1 house, 2 to 4, 2 house, 4 to 6, 1 house, 6 to 8, 5 house, 8 to 10, 6 house, 10 to 12, 2 house, and 12 to 14, 3 house. Now we see the solution to this. We do this by direct method. Now class number of plants and class mark is given to you. We find the number of houses. Okay. So solution number of plants 0 to 2. So the class mark will be 0 plus 2 by 2. So 2 by 2, 1. Second 2 to 4. So 2 plus 4, 6. 6 by 2, 3. Third class mark 4 plus 6, 10. 10 by 2. 5, 6 plus 8, 14, 14 by 2, 7, 8 plus 10, 18, 18 by 2, 9, 10 plus 12, 22 by 2, 11, 12 plus 12, 14, 26 by 2, that is 30. So class mark is given as 0 to 2 is 1, 2 to 4, 3, 4 to 6, 5, 6 to 8, 7, 8 to 10, 9, 10 to 12, 11 and 12 to 14, 13. Number of houses, that is our frequency given to us. 1, 2, 1, 5, 6, 2, 3. Now, class mark is your XI. Number of houses is your FI. Now, we multiply FI into XI. So, 1 into 1, 0, 1. 3 into 2, 6. 5 into 1, 5. 7 into 5, 35. 9 into 6, 54. 11 into 2, 22. 13 into 3, 39. That is our FIXI. Now we add up all the FI. That is sigma FI, which equals to 20. Similarly, we add up FIXI. That is sigma FIXI. That is equals to 162. Direct method formula x bar equals to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. So 162 upon 20, that is 8.1 plant. The mean of the data is 8.1. Since the value of xi fi are small, so we have used direct method to find mean. This is sum number 4th of the exercise. 30 women were examined in a hospital by doctor and the number of heartbeats per minute were recorded and summarized as follow. Find the mean heartbeats per minute for this woman choosing a suitable table. Number of heartbeats per minute is given as 65 to 68. This is the class range. 68 to 71, 71 to 74, 74 to 77, 77 to 80, 80 to 83, 83 to 86. Number of movements in that group 65 to 68, 2, 68 to 71, 4, 71 to 74, 3, 74 to 77, 8, 77 to 87, 80 to 83, 4, 83 to 86, 2. We are finding out the class values for, that is class mark, mid value of the interval. Now 65 plus 68. That is 133, and when we divide by 2 we get 66.5. Now group data means you have equal value. So when you subtract the lower limit second with the lower minute first, that is 68 minus 65, we get 3 as the class length. Now if you add that class length to the class mark, being a group data, you get equal class mark. Now 65 to 68, 66.5. Class length is 3. So add 66.5 plus 3, that is 69.5 for 68 to 68, 71. Now 71 to 74, add 3 to the above, that is 72.5. 74 to 77, add 3 again, 75.5. 77 to 80, you get 78.5. Now 80 to 83, again in the previous add 3, so 81.5. And 83 to 86, we get 84.5. You can do it in that way also. 83 plus 86, you get the answer to that 169 divided by 2, that is 84.5. 5. That way also we can get, and adding 3, that is the easier method. Now frequency is given as 2, 4, 3, 8, 7, 4, 2. So sum of this frequency equals to 30. Now we multiply Fi into Xi. So 2 into 66.5 is 133. 4 into 69.5 is 278. 3 into 72.5 is 217.5. 8 into 75.5 is 604. 7 into 78.5 is 549.5. 4 into 81.5 is 326. 2 into 84.5 is 169. Now sum of this FIXI is 2277. So mean by direct method is given by the formula X bar equals to sigma FIXI upon sigma FI. So 2277 divided by 30, that is equals to 75.9. So we have seen two sums related to direct method. Let us see one more sum based on direct method. Question number 8. A class teacher has the following absentee record of 40 students of class for the whole term. Find the mean number of days students was absent. Number of days is given in the range 0 to 6, 6 to 10, 10 to 14, 14 to 20, 20 to 28, 28 to 38, 38 to 40. Number of students in that range is 11, 10, 7, 4, 4, 3, 1 respectively. Now to find by direct method, the first thing is to find the class mark, that is mid value xi. Now 0 to 6 is 0 plus 6 divided by 2, that is 3. What is the difference where each class comes out to be 6 minus 0, that is 6, and 14 minus 10, that is 4. So here the difference are not equal. So we go by the direct method, because here values for each class interval, the length is different. So we find out the class mark as 0 plus 6, that is 3, 6 plus 10, 16 divided by 2, that is 8, 10 plus 14, 24 divided by 2, 12, 14 plus 20 divided by 2, that is 17, 20 plus 28, 48 divided by 2, 4, 24, 28 plus 38 divided by 2, that is 66 upon 2, 33, and 38 plus 40, that is plus 40, that is 78 divided by 2, that is 39. So class mark by group, as the length is not equal, we have to find, we can't add the same number here, okay? So we have to find the class mark by adding upper limit and lower limit and divide by 2. Now FIXI, so 11 into 3, 33, 10 into 8, 80, 7 into 12, 84, 4 into 17, 68, 4 into 24, 96, 3 into 33, 99, and 1 into 39, 39. So sum of the frequency, that is FI, sigma FI equals to 40. And sum of the frequency sigma FIXI equals to 499. So by direct method, the formula is mean number of days equals to sigma FIXI upon sigma FI, that is 499 upon 40, which is equals to 12.48 days. The second method is about assumed mean. Now assume mean method of finding mean. Here the step first is classify the data into interval and find the corresponding frequency of each class. Second step, find the class mark by taking the mid value of upper and lower class limit. Step third, take one of the xi, usually in the middle, as assumed mean and denote it by A. Step 4, find the deviation of A from each of the x, that is di equals to xi minus A. Fifth step, find the mean of deviation d equals to sigma xi di upon sigma fi. Calculate the mean as x bar equals to A plus sigma xi di upon sigma fi. Now this is the formula for assumed mean. A is the assumed mean. The relation between mean of deviation and mean di equals to xi minus a. And when we are summing over this x, we get sigma di equals to sigma xi minus sigma a. And dividing by sigma fi, that is n, we get sigma di equals to sigma xi upon sigma fi minus sigma a equals to sigma a upon n. So that get cancelled, so we get di, where n is the total number of observation, d equals to x bar minus a. 14.1 third question we see. The following distribution shows the daily pocket allowance of a children of a locality. The mean pocket allowance is given as 18. Find the missing frequency. Now here we go by this step deviation assumed mean method. Daily pocket allowance is given as 11 to 13, 13 to 15, 15 to 17, 17 to 19, 19 to 21, 21 to 23, and 23 to 25. So what is the class length over here? Class length is 2. How we get? 13 minus 11, that is equals to 2. Now frequency, that is number of children given to us, is 7, 6, 9, 13. 19 to 21 is unknown. There we write it as F. And 21 to 23 is 5. And 23 to 25, 4. Now, first step is to find the class mark. That is, we have to find the mid values of each class. So, 11 to 13, 12 is the mid value. What is the difference? We get 2. So, add next mid value will be 12 plus 2, 14. 14 plus 2, 16. 16 plus 2, 18. 18 plus 2, 20. 20 plus 2, 22. 22 plus 2, 24. Frequency given to us is 7, 6, 9, 13, F, 5, 4. Now, our first step is to suppose the assumed mean. Whenever unknown is given, we can select that as the assumed mean. But here we think it in one way. Take the highest frequency. Before that highest frequency, the same line, that class mark of that highest frequency will be our assumed mean. From this highest frequency, we find it as 13. So the class mark 13, near 13 is 18. So let 18 equals to our assumed mean. Now, what is our first step? This assumed mean is A. So di, what you want to find is subtract with this xi. So di equals to xi minus 18. So 12 minus 18, minus 6. 14 minus 18, minus 4. 16 minus 18, minus 2. 18 minus 18, 0. 20 minus 18, 2. 22 minus 18, 4. 24 minus 18, 6. So this is our di. Now we multiply fi di. That is 7 into minus 6, minus 42. 6 into minus 4, minus 24. 13 into 0, 0. Sorry, one left out. 19 into minus 2, minus 18. 13 into 0, 0. F into 2, that is 2F, 5 into 4, 20, 4 into 6, 24. Now, sum of the frequency, one unknown is there, F. So, leaving that, what is the total? We get 44. So, sigma Fi will be 44 plus F. Same way, Fi di sum, 2F you leave it, rest you add or subtract whatever value, we get minus 40. So, minus 40 plus 2F. So sigma Fi di equals to 2F minus 40. Now by direct assumed mean method formula, we get mean equals to A plus sigma Fi di upon sigma Fi. That is our formula. Mean is given as, total mean is given as 18. That is in our question only. Assumed mean is also 18. Now, sigma Fi di is 2F minus 40 upon 44 plus F. Now, 18 minus 18 will be 0. So, the denominator, when we take it in that cross multiplication, we get 0 into 44 plus F, that is 0. So, 2F minus 40 equals to 0. 2F equals to 40. So, F equals to 40 upon 2. that is 20. Same frequency by assuming method is 40 divided by 2, that is 20.